The minute.
Yeah, yes, mommy. So you start your presentation, please.
あの、ファイルホームタッチ挿入って一番上のところにあるあスライドショーしてもらったらいいと思います先生。その右そのまま右行っていただいて挿入デザイン画面切り替えでスライドショーですね。その右もっと右、ね、もっと右ですね。もっと矢印を右に行ってもらってもう一個右もそのスライドショーです。もう一個右、
はいはい、
それを押してもらってで最初から一番左に戻ってもらって、その下の列の最初から押してもらえれば大丈夫です。はい、それ大丈夫です。そこを押してください。
Okay. Sorry. Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm Kenji Maeda. I'm very happy to be here. It is a great honor to be given this opportunity to present here, thanks to Dr. Mahesh Bari. I'm not in the academic position now.So I can't pick up academic topics here for today. I have a private practice, so I will talk about my practice at first and then talk about the medical insurance system in Japan. Maybe the same thing about Dr. Tsutomi mentioned. And I have nothing to declare about the financial relationships.I am living on the outskirts of Tokyo. The population of my city is 230,000 and increasing year by year. There are 84 clinics, including mine, and 4 hospitals in the city. Approximately 50 clinics are run by internists.The two of the hospitals are general hospitals, and the rest are facilities for rehabilitation. This is a scene from my city. This is my clinic. It's an outpatient clinic. Many patients are old people with chronic diseases such as hypertension, diabetes, hyperlipidemia, and so on.And of course, some are patients with acute illness such as fever, abdominal pain, respiratory infections, and so on. This is the entrance of my clinic. And this is from the screen of electronic health record. This is a list of the patients who booked appointments by internet or by phone.I usually see 70 to 120 patients on the everyday basis. I know it's too many compared to the number of patients in the USA and other countries. But it's a reality because we are working under the conception, free access and low cost with official rate. Also, we vaccinate against various infections in the clinic.Including measles, mumps, rubella, varicella, polio, hepatitis B, pneumococcus, HIV, Japanese encephalitis, flu, HPV, and COVID-19. I made 44,000 jabs of COVID-19 in this year. Picture this. This is an example of a daily practice in the office. It's a usual scene. A 45-year male hypertensive patient paying an outpatient visit once in a month. He is taking amlodipine 5 mg per day. His blood pressure was 130 and 80 today. The same medication was prescribed for 4 weeks. Maybe the same thing, maybe.Can be seen in India too. How much do your patient pay after the examination? The doctor's fee for returning patients and medication cost, pharmacy charge, prescription fee, drug information providing charge, specific disease management fee, All the total amount will be 5,950 yen, which is 51.3 US dollars. This patient has insurance card. He has to pay 30% of the whole sum, which is 1,790 yen, which means 15.4 US dollars. I think it may be far cheaper than USA because this is an official charge determined by government and doctor fee is said to be very low. If the patient is an old person, the final charge will be cheaper. In principle, the older people, 75 years, over 75 years old, have to pay 10% of the whole sum, unless he or she is earning. The same treatment with the amlodipine results in 595 yen, or 5.1 US dollars, thanks to the medical care system for elderly. I will mention about this system later again. The patient visits medical facilities and receives examination and medication and pays 10% to 30% of the medical charge. The medical facilities claim for the rest of the charge, sending medical bills or receipts to the insurer. Then 70% to 90% of the medical charge will be paid to the medical facilities. This is how insurance works. And there are two types of insurance. The largest one is the National Health Insurance. This is for individual proprietors, pensioners, or irregular employers. Almost all of the retired persons will join this kind of insurance. Another one is the social insurance system. There are three entities in this social insurance system. The first one, Health Insurance Association, is for salaried employees of large corporations. And the association or union administered health insurance is for salaried employees of small and medium-sized enterprises. And the last one, mutual aid association, is for civil officers. As I told before, the elderly persons older than 75 years old can use the medical care system for elderly. Half was covered by expenditure from nation, prefecture, municipality at the ratio of 4:1:1 respectively, and 40% from support fund from various insurers. We have another system for the patients who should pay high cost due to advances of medical technology. As, for example, if the total medical charge in 1 month is 1 million yen, and the patient has an insurance card of 30% co-payment, he should pay 300,000 yen. But the system calculates his individual limit. In this case, it is 87,430 yen. So 212,570 yen will be repaid. This system is to ensure that the financial burden on the patient does not become too great. If the patient is older, the repaid amount will be bigger. In this case, he is a low-income old person with the age varying 70 to 74 years old. which means co-payment is 20%. The individual limit of payment should be 8,000 yen. When he paid and the same treatment for the same treatment, 200,000 yen at the medical institution, 192,000 yen would be repaid later. Let me explain about the characteristics of Japanese health system here. Maybe the same thing was told by Dr. Tsutsumi. The principle is that covering all the citizens by public medical insurance and free access, freedom of choice for medical institution, and high quality medical services with low cost based on the social insurance system. Spending the public subsidy to maintain universal health insurance coverage. These are merits to all the patients, but on the other hand, they may be demerits to us doctors because the doctor's fee is said to be very low and we have to see many patients compared to other countries. But I'm just complaining. Our system is a great one, I think. As you may know, Japan has the longest life expectancy of any country. The life expectancy of Japanese ladies, 57, and for men, 81. And please read these red bars. This is the population of age of people over 100 years old. And the number of people aged 100 or more has hit a record high for the 51st year in a row. A survey by the Health and Welfare Ministry shows a total of 86,510 centenarians recently. The number is up by 6,000 from a year ago, and 88% are women. The oldest person of all is 118. She's not just the oldest person in Japan, but in the world, as recognized by Guinness World Records. They say she's aiming to stay healthy at least until the age of 120.
Dr. Maeda, can we request you to wrap it up since we are just under 1 minute?
Pardon?
Can I request you to please complete the talk, conclude the talk?
I'm sorry, I can't understand.
Can we finish the conclusion part?
Yeah.
Sir, running short of time, so please conclude as early as possible.
Okay. It's before I close the speech, I'd like to mention about future problems. The same thing about the topics that Dr. Tsutsumi said. So, the increasing cost of maintaining the social security system of aging society is a big problem. Longevity may be a happy event, but Japan's aging society and the decrease of young population are causing a decline in the size of their labor force. I envy India because India has a huge population and with many young people, and stable domestic demand and manpower has been achieved. But your country may have some other problems. I hope we will resolve those problems together in the future. I'm sure if we put our heads together, we will be able to figure it out. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Maeda.